Hello students, in the previous lecture of evolution, we had studied about evolution, its meanings and its description as by Herbert Spencer and Aristotle. We also studied the principles of evolution. We had learnt about speciation and its types. In this lecture, we will study other principles of evolution apart from speciation. So there are five principles of evolution: speciation, irreversibility, parallelism and convergence, adaptation radiation and extinction. We have already studied speciation and its types in the previous video. In this video, we will study the rest of the principles. Irreversibility. Louis Dollo, a French-born Belgian paleontologist, proposed the principle of irreversibility in 1890, also called the Dollo's law of irreversibility. Dollo's law states that an organism is unable to return even partially to a previous stage already realized in the ranks of its ancestors. He was of the view that once an animal has passed through a number of stages, a reversion stage by stage to the original ancestral condition does not occur. Irreversibility is a descriptive generalization and not a property of living organism. Dollo's law has been often refuted by evidence that evolutionary specialization can be undone. For instance, reversible evolution has been observed on a relatively short evolutionary timescale in the peppered moth. In 19th century, a dark morph of the moth emerged in response to air pollution during the Industrial Revolution and became the dominant color morph, almost completely replacing the light-colored form. By the late 20th century, however, the light morph was on the rise again, its increase coincident with the decline of air pollution in England. In the studies of primate evolution, irreversibility is an important principle. The dentition of a given form is the often crucial evidence of its ancestral and descendant status with respect to another form. Once a tooth of a particular series, incisors, canines, premolar or molar, is lost, it does not reoccur again in the series in the same form. Change in dentition is irreversible. Parallelism and convergence. Parallelism is usually restricted to the development of similar adaptive features in animals that are related, such as animals belonging to the same order. The parallel resemblances are most likely the realization of a genetic potential that is present in the entire group. Convergence, on the other hand, is defined as development of similarities in adaptive relationships and structures in two animal species or major groups that are not closely related. Hence, parallelism and convergence imply that close phylogenetic relationship does not exist. It is difficult to classify all cases of similar evolution as convergent or parallel. The old world monkeys and the new world monkeys provide excellent example of parallelism between groups living together. Since they appear to have evolved in parallel from a prosimian ancestor that probably lived at least 35 million years ago, an example of convergent evolution is the incisor tooth comb of flying lemur and tooth comb of various prosimian primates formed by lower incisor and canines. Adaptive radiation. Adaptive radiation is the process in which organisms diversify rapidly from an ancestral species into a multitude of new forms, particularly when a change in the environment makes new resources available, creates new challenges, or opens new environmental niches. Starting with a recent single ancestor, this process results in speciation and phenotypic adaptation of an array of species exhibiting different morphological and physiological traits. The prototypical example of adaptive radiation is the flinch speciation on the Galapagos, which is called the Darwin flinches, but examples are known from around the world. According to Simpson, adaptive radiation is the rapid proliferation of new species from ancestral groups. In this photo, we see the adaptive radiation of the Darwin's flinches. We see how flinches in the ground evolve to the warble flinches and tree flinches and how different they are. Four features used to identify an adaptive radiation. A common ancestry of component species. Specifically, a recent ancestry. Note that this is not the same as monophyly, in which all descendants of a common ancestors are included. A phenogenetic environment correlation. A significant association between environments and morphological and physiological traits used to exploit those environments. Trait utility. The performance or fitness advantage of trait values in their corresponding environments. The rapid speciation. Presence of one or more bursts in emergence of new species around the time that ecologically and phenotypically divergence is underway. So in this lecture, we learned about the other principles of evolution apart from speciation. We learned about irreversibility, parallelism and convergence, adaptive radiation, what are the four features used to identify an adaptive radiation, extinction, what are the causes of extinction. In the next video, we will study about the theories of evolution. Further, we will study about extinction. Extinction is termination of an organism or of a group of organisms, that is taxon, usually a species. The moment of extinction is generally considered to be the death of the last individual of the species, although the capacity to breed and recover may have been lost before this point, because a species' potential range may vary very large. Determining this moment is difficult and is usually done retrospectively. This difficulty leads to a phenomena such as Lazarus taxa, where a species presumed extinct abruptly reappears, typically in the fossil record, after a period of apparent absence. Moving forward, let us see the causes of extinction. Extinction occurs due to genetic and demographic phenomena. For example, there is change in the genetics or the demographic phenomena. Genetic pollution, bad genes coming into the population. Habitat degradation, the habitat of a population being continuously degraded. Predation, competition and diseases. Co-extinction, for example, a species that is dependent on the other species, if the independent species is extinct, the other species also get extinct. Then the sixth cause is climate change.